Hello everyone. In this video, we will see how to export an RDL report in the necessary format using the Bold Reports Report Writer. The Report Writer is a class library that lets the user export reports defined in RDL format as PDF, Word, Excel, or CSV documents. It is mainly used to export reports without previewing them. Let's get started. First, I'll create a new ASP.NET Core web application. I open Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project. I choose ASP.NET Core web application model view controller. And then I click Next. I change the project name and click Next. For this demo, I set the target framework to .NET 6.0. I click Create. The new ASP.NET Core web application will be created. Next, let me install the necessary NuGet packages in the application. In the Solution Explorer tab, I right-click the project and choose Manage NuGet Packages. In the Browse tab, I search for the boldreports.net.core package and install it in the core application. The dependent packages will be installed automatically on installing the boldreports.net.core package. Next, I create a folder named Resources in the www root folder in my application. This is where we will keep the RDL reports. For this video, I am going to add the sales-order-detail.rdl file to the Resources folder. You will find the sales-order-detail.rdl file downloadable link in the video description. Next, I need to add the API method to generate the exported document in the controller. For that, I open the home controller.cs file from the controller folder. To read the report file from the application, I use the iHosting environment interface by importing the Microsoft.ASP.NET Core.Hosting namespace and injecting iHosting environment through dependency injection. Next, I add the export method to the controller to export using the HTTP POST action. In the export method, I am going to read the report file as a stream and use it with the report writer. To do that, first I create a variable named report path and assign the path value that has the report. Next, I create an instance for the file stream using report path. Then, I create the memory stream to copy the value from file stream to use it with the report writer. This copy process will be helpful to avoid file access problems in the server while running the application on the server. Then, I create an object for the Bold Reports Writer. I create a variable to store the file name, file type, and export format for the exported file. I copy this code from the documentation and paste it in the export method. It determines the file format for saving the sales order details report and sets corresponding values for the file name, type, and format based on the chosen format. Next, I load the report stream to the writer. I export the report to the stream using reportwriter.save and pass the format that needs to be generated by the report writer. I assign 0 as the value of the memory stream.position to read the file properly from the report writer. Next, I create a file stream result with an exported memory stream value to get the exported document on the client side. I assign the file name value to the file stream result.file download name to be used for download. Now, I move on to the implementation to use the API on the client side. In the client side, we are going to add an option to select the export file type and a generate button to get documents based on the selection of the export type. First, I open the index.cshtml file from views/home folder. I copy the code with that selection option and the generate button from the documentation and paste it by removing the existing code. I save the file. Next, I register the license token to remove the license validation message. In this demo, I am going to use the online license token. License tokens can be generated in the subscription section of the Bold Reports accounts page. I open the program.cs file and enter the code snippet to register the license token. I have provided the link to a video on registering a license using online license tokens and offline license keys in this video's description. Now, everything is ready to load the report writer. I build and run the application. You will see the option to select the export file type and the generate button. By clicking the generate button, the report will be exported in PDF format. When opening the downloaded file, you will see the exported report. If you want the report in Word format, select that. And then click the generate button. You will see the report is exported. When opening the downloaded file, you will see the exported Word file. In this demo, you saw how to create an ASP.NET Core application and configure the server-side and client-side to export a report using the Bold Reports report writer. I have provided a documentation link in the description below for the steps that we followed in this video. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.